Hi everyone! In this part, we are going to focus on input filters and conditions. We will talk about several types and you will learn how to define them. Also, we will show you everything on illustrative examples. Our first condition is indicator condition. And in this picture, you can see already familiar strategy, where right after the bar closes above long-term simple moving average, the position is opened. And then, when the bar closes below, the position is closed. Now let's switch to strategy quant and let's see how to define such a strategy and condition. And you are going to work with a spanking new project, so click on new here at the top part. And in this window, choose using full wizard and create basic strategy template. Click on select. Conditions are put in this bookmark, this first bookmark trading signals. So now click on add first condition and it is bar closes above moving average. So let's find it. Bar closes above moving average, double click. And let's change the period to 200. Again, click on confirm. And because this is entry condition, we put it into the long entry signals. And what do we need now is also to close the position. So we are going to add condition into the long exit signal. So click again, add another condition and choose bar closes below moving average. And again, change the period to 200 and click on confirm. Now let's set the symbol and engine here in settings. So I'm going to choose MetaTrader 5 netted and our symbol is going to be ESMT5. Click on run full backtest and also go to trading options and mark this option store chart data. Again, click on run full backtest. Now you can see here results of the strategy. Now let's show how we would directly define the condition that is predefined here. It means to decompose it to its elementary conditions and place them in the AlgoWizard. So let's go and check the graph. Go to list of trades and open the first one. And let's analyze what conditions the candlestick has to meet. So we could say that it closed above the moving average. First of all, let's zoom it a little bit. And let's work with, for example, this candle. The first condition is that the close point of the candle is above this line. And the second condition is that the open point is below the line. Both of these conditions have to be met at once. And now we are going to compare these conditions to a simple moving average with period 200. So let's go back to editor and define it. First of all, delete the condition that we set before. So click on add new condition. Firstly, choose comparison and it's lower. Click on confirm. And our first value is open. And the second one is moving average with period 200. And let's confirm it. The second condition goes like this. The close position of the candle must be greater than the moving average with period 200. So comparison is greater. Click on confirm. Here, let's set close. Confirm it. And again, the right value is going to be moving average with period 200. Click on confirm and run full backtest. And like this, you can define any conditions. Let me show you also one more option, adding opening or closing brackets. Here, click on this icon, click on add opening brackets, and then on closing brackets. That's for the case when you like to string the conditions and set a concrete hierarchy, for example, you can use this option, just in the same way like you do it in math. Well, I hope this example was sufficient for you. Anyways, here you can choose from all possible comparisons, for example, then from all possible functions, and of course, from all the indicators that we know, and also price levels.